Hi friends, so how is the diet going on? We already have spoke enough about keto diet, and we already have seen the vlogs or how to plan your day-to-day foods. Today I wanted to talk something interesting in keto diet. Yeah, this point which I'm gonna talk today is really important, interesting, whatever you say. It's the most wanted thing in keto diet. If someone is following keto diet, they should go through this video, because this is something about electrolytes are one of the most important thing when your body is transforming from the carb diet to keto diet, because your body is going to produce those ketones which start using fat as the fuel to the body, and they start cutting down the fat existing in the body. In such cases, what happens, the water in the body gets flushes out. So in the high carb diet we have water retention, but in low carb and keto diet there is water release from the body, which means the water from the body is getting exaggerated. So there's no water in the body, there is no electrolytes in the body. The minerals and the electrolytes gets flushed out from the body very soon in this diet. So the main electrolytes which we have to refill are magnesium, sodium and potassium. Okay, we even can think about calcium supplements and chlorides also, but the most three important things are magnesium, potassium and sodium. So let's see what are the sources for this and how to backfill this, and what are the symptoms of deficiency of these minerals. Yeah, so first let's talk about sodium. Yeah, sodium, when I say sodium, everyone will think about the salt which we use, which we intake. Yeah, that is sodium. So what happens is the normal table salt which we use doesn't have required amount of sodium which needs to be taken on a ketogenic diet, because we are releasing the water. Yeah, so what happens is the sodium which we are getting, the table salt, is a mixture of chemicals also. So in ketogenic diet it is strongly recommended that you take the rock salt or sea salt, the raw one, or the Himalayan pink salt. Yeah, because these are not refined as such, so these are pure in form and have plenty of sodium in it, which doesn't have chemical mixed. So these are really good for this diet, specifically for keto diet. So how do you know that you are sodium deficient? Yeah, sodium deficiency is easiest thing to know in keto diet. I mean, the symptoms are very even in this diet. So if you are sodium deficient in this diet, you will have the first symptom which I have come through was heart palpation. It's like I was able to hear my heartbeat in my throat, in my ear. So the heart palpation was high. It is like whatever I hear in my heartbeat, the same thing I used to hear in the neck region or in the ears. I was surprised to hear that. I'm like, what is this happening with me? So that's when I came to know I'm sodium deficient. That these heart palpations are more in when you are in sodium deficit, that too especially when you are on keto diet. You even feel fatigue, you even feel nausea, you feel you are so weak, you are constipated. These are the main symptoms of sodium. When you have these symptoms in the transition phase, you are supposed to increase your sodium levels. Yeah, increasing the sodium levels isn't taking medicine or something. Try doing it naturally. Try adding salt, more salt, to your diet regimen, like on the salad sprinkle salt, or if you are having water, mix salt and have. You will definitely see a huge difference. I mean, if you're feeling very weak also, that corrects when you are having the salt water, because you are giving the sodium to your body directly. Yeah, especially in keto diet it is recommended that you have 1 spoon of salt in a day, wherein in normal diets it is 250th, or I mean like 1/4 or 1/5 spoon is enough. But when you are on keto diet, the sodium should be more, which means you should give almost 1 spoon of salt in your daily food. Try avoiding table salt, which we take, these tartars and all. I mean, I'm not against them. Normal diets it's fine, but the required amount of sodium for this diet isn't available in this salt. So try having Himalayan pink salt or the rock salt, the pure form of rock salt or sea salt. That will sort out the issues. Yeah, and the other sources for the sodium are palak. The spinach has sodium in it, so you can consume spinach in all the dishes. I have seen many people don't like palak soup or something, so try having this palak in the dishes, whatever you prepare. Like you can include palak in, egg scramble, or you can include palak in chicken, mutton, or paneer, whatever you are preparing. You can just mix it in that and have it. Yeah, having so will increase your sodium level. And palak is good in many forms. Like it is good in magnesium also. So there are many issues which get solved while you are using palak. So I normally was using 2 to 3 bunches of palak in a day. Yeah, that really helps a lot. Try doing it, friends. Don't give up just because you are on keto flu. These keto flu symptoms are very normal. These says that you are adapting to keto, because these days you used your body the sugar as fuel. Now you are gonna use the fat as fuel. So the transition phase is on. You just be strong in this transition phase, and once you are done with this transition phase, you will never look back, because you're gonna lose weight tremendously. And the worst part, the fat in the body is the worst part that is gonna cut down. So please be strong in this phase and try increasing your electrolytes. Now we are done with sodium. The second one is magnesium. I'm going to give details about magnesium. You also have headache, head heaviness when you are low on your sodium levels. So please take care of this. So there is one more kind of option for us to increase the sodium levels, which is chicken broth or chicken soup, which we call. Yeah, in my previous videos I already suggested how to make it. It's just that take 1/2 kg of chicken and a little bit of ginger, garlic, salt, red chili powder and garam masala, and add 2 liters of water and pressure cook it without a whistle, and let it sit for 35 to 40 minutes there. Yeah, let it cook properly, and you can add more salt to it and just remove it and keep it in your refrigerator. You can drink these soups when you feel low on sodium levels, as explained. Yeah, this will really help and make you retain your energy back. Because we add salt and store it, this is also very good rich source of sodium. Try adding Himalayan pink salt to it. That will really help and give more weightage to your sodium levels. And one more thing, for sodium you can have all the green leafy vegetables, because all these vegetables have sodium in them. So try consuming any one which is available for you. If not palak, spinach, try having any green leafy vegetables which are available for you. These are really this will really help to keep up the sodium levels for you. So the people who are deficient in keto diet of magnesium, these will not have proper sleep, because this is a important vital mineral for sleep. So when you are low on magnesium, what happens is your sleep pattern would be changed. It is not normal. You won't get sleep, you can't sleep properly, or you feel muscle weakness. Yeah, you feel that these muscles are very heavy to lift or something like that. Then it could be you are deficient on your magnesium. That means deficient in the sense, it is not some medical word I am using. I'm just trying to say that you are low on your magnesium levels. In a sense, when you are on normal diet, what happens is you are consuming magnesium from different sources which we don't track. But when you are specially on keto diet, you have limited resources or limited items to take. In such cases, there will be this electrolyte deficiency. So what you have to do is you have to read your body, you have to understand your body and fulfill those minerals which you are missing. So when you are deficient on magnesium, you can understand by your sleep is not correct. Yeah, you feel that you have heavy muscles, or you have incorrect heartbeat kind of stuff. Yeah, when these things happen, or you are constipated, when these things happen, you can increase your magnesium levels. How do you increase your magnesium levels? There are very minimal sources of magnesium in this diet. Yeah, let's see what are those. Avocados are very good in magnesium. You can have 2 avocados a day. I understand that we don't get these avocados everywhere. So almonds has magnesium, and even spinach has magnesium. So I would strongly recommend taking spinach 2 to 3 bunches in this diet, in the transition phase at least. Yeah, so once the transition phase is gone, you are already keto adapted, then I don't think you will need it. At least for this transition phase, please try upping your electrolytes in this form. For magnesium, try having spinach soups in the morning, or adding spinach here and there. Yeah, that would really give a good magnesium intake. Or if you don't have this option, then contact your physician and try taking magnesium supplements. If you're feeling very drowsy in the morning and can't sleep, it's just like you're closing your eyes and you're like, oh my god, what is happening? Increase your magnesium levels. That will really help here. Yeah. And the next one is potassium. Whenever you are low on your potassium levels, you feel kind of fatigued, in the sense feel that cramps, the cramp kind of stuffs. Yeah, you will have leg cramps especially. You feel that the bones are not supporting you, or you have lot of sugar craving, or you feel that you are deprived, you crave for carbs also sometimes, then your potassium is not sufficient. So you should take care of your potassium levels. So these potassiums are kind of very less in the nature, in the sense you won't get kind of potassium very less. So we have to try taking that cocoa powder, not the chocolate sweets, not that, the raw cocoa powder. You can try making out fat bombs out of it using coconut oil and stevia and try consuming it. This is really rich in potassium and it helps you a lot. Yeah, so whenever you are whenever you are low on your potassium levels, you can understand it by looking at the cramps itself. Many people in keto diet get these cramps and they are like, oh my god, what is happening? So in such cases, increase your potassium. You can talk to your doctor before this diet and tell them that you're gonna do this diet and these are the mineral electrolytes deficient. So when I get this, what to do? First, try having the natural forms of the minerals which I have explained. If you can't or don't get any of this, then you can go for the medications whichever your physician suggests. So how to increase potassium? Avocados has potassium in them. They are very good and rich sources of potassium. Green leafy vegetables, all green leafy vegetables have potassium in them. And nuts to some extent have potassium. You can have pumpkin seeds or sunflower nuts. Yeah, those are also good, and these are keto friendly also. So you can go for them for potassium. Even have mushrooms. Yeah. Mushrooms are very good and rich in potassium. I love mushrooms. What about you? Please leave the comment. How did you go through your keto flu? If already you are in keto, what is the process you followed and how easily you got through this keto flu? Or was it really tough for you? Then what are the actions or what are the smart choices you have taken? Please leave in the comments. It could be helpful for other users also. Yeah. Thank you for watching. Do like, share and comment, friends, and do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.